An American freelance journalist, Matthew Van Dyke, went missing in March while he was in the country. And since then, the freelance journalist has been in the country's infamous Abu Salim prison in solitary confinement, we're told. On Wednesday, he escaped. I'm pleased to say we have on the phone Matthew's mother, Sharon. She joins us now on the line from Baltimore. Sharon, first of all, this must be a tremendously happy day for your family as you get this long-awaited news. But first of all, tell our viewers, what was Matthew doing in Libya to begin with?
He went to Libya to support his Libyan friends. He had spent 2 months in Libya in 2008 and had just really, he loved the country and the people. And as he heard from them, when the events in the Middle East started to unfold, he felt that he needed to go to Benghazi and spend time with his friends, not in the fighting part of the cause, but in developing a democracy and just do think tank type activities with them, talk about what life is like in America, about, again, the democracy and the rights that we have and that they could have. And also, he is a freelance journalist, so it was important to him to take his camera and his external hard drives and his computer and do some writing. He's been writing a book about his journey through the Middle East since 2007.
So as you describe it, he went for peaceful purposes. How did he end up in prison?
He went on the 13th of March to, or 12th of March, I guess, the town of Brega with some friends. He had never been to Brega, to take some pictures and visit and see the area. And from what we understand, Gaddafi's forces at that time came into Brega and captured the town the next day on the 13th when he was there.
And at that point, from what I read, the last time you spoke to him was March 12th.
That's correct.
Talk to me about... Go ahead.
His girlfriend, Lauren Fisher, spoke with him in the morning that day, and I spoke with him that afternoon. Then on March the 13th, neither one of us could reach him via his cell phone, but he sent GPS coordinates that day to us that put him in the town of Brega. And that was the last time we had any contact with him until today.
I can only imagine a frantic time, a stressful time for your entire family, and then today happens. You get the phone call.
Yes.
Talk to me about everything that happened today.
He called Lauren on the phone and talked with her and gave her number for me to contact him, and she talked to him for about 10 minutes and then she called me because he borrowed a cell phone from a Libyan. So we knew we couldn't talk long, but we each wanted to have an opportunity to speak with him. She called me and I then immediately called him, and first thing he said was, "Hi, Mom," which was the one thing, two words that I've been waiting to hear for 6 months. And he sounded fine, sounded just like himself. He said he was in good health, but he has spent the entire time in solitary confinement. And as he said, sitting in a cell staring at a wall for almost 6 months.
And his release, was he able to give you any detail about how that came about?
He actually wasn't released. They escaped from the prison. Prisoners came to his cell and knocked off with some type of tool or rock or something, the lock on the cell, and actually took him with them. So he walked out of the prison. He said there were hundreds of prisoners leaving, and he walked with some of these men out of the prison, and after a period of time, and I don't know how long they walked, but during that time, there was a Libyan, a wealthy Libyan, who invited them into his compound and gave them food, and that's where he called us from.
I know that, like any mother, all you want right now is to see your son, to have him safely home. What are the plans to get him back here to the United States?
Well, I've been working all along with our State Department and Congressman Ruppersberger's office. So, you know, it's in the works for him to come home. We're waiting for Matthew to be able to either reach us via internet or get a cell phone, so I can give him more information, and Lauren will have the same information. So one of us will be in contact with him, and so he can make arrangements with State Department people or people representing our government in Tripoli so he can come home.
Now, if there's any chance that he could possibly be watching us and this conversation, what is it you'd like to say to him?
To Matthew?
Yes.
Well, I think the things that we said, I'm so glad that he's, you know, that he's better than just okay, because we had all kinds of thoughts of what he was going through. Glad certainly to know that he was, I guess, treated fairly, other than not having anyone to talk to or any interact with anyone over those months. And he needs to come home and spend time with Lauren. It's been a rough road for her, too.
Yeah, it's been a rough
road. We're just glad to know that he's safe, and we know he'll be home. But neither one of us ever thought that he was a casualty of the war. We both always believed that he was somewhere and okay and would get back to the States.